Honestly, guys, I did not think that I would like an auto battler this much. Hi, welcome back to another Princess Connect video. My name is Lace, and I feel like I really need to make this video. Today, I'm going to be talking about how I personally feel about the game, the state of it, and how I feel that it's been handled so far. That's actually a pretty good summary of what I'm going to be talking about today. Before you veterans click away, I think the second half of the video is probably a lot more interesting to you, but like the first half, I'm just going to be going through my own personal views as to how the game is. And it'd be interesting if you guys actually would dispute some of the points, because I know like some of these points like are going to, some people are not going to be very happy with it. But with that being said, let's just get into it. So let's talk about the game itself. Take this as kind of like a review. A review from somebody who actually likes slash loves actually the game and has actually spent more than just a couple of days playing it. So for context, I'm a soft launch player. That means that I've been playing for about like 2 months now. So let's start with like this interface, right? Like it all feels very modern, very cohesive, you know, like it's got a scheme going on and it's very well polished, though it does feel a little bit aged. If you guys know like Arknights or Blue Archive, which is a new game I'm playing, those like feel very sleek and feel very fast. Some people could like chalk it up to just like, oh man, Precon is like more fantasy based. It's more about magic rather than like, you know, guns and shit. But otherwise, like in comparison to another one that always comes to mind, it's called Illusion Connect. Like that one felt just like really, really cheap. I think you guys know what I mean, right? It's kind of like really obvious when a game has been put together just to be like a cash grab. An 8 out of 10 for me, but like, man, I remember when I started playing Arknights, it was like a solid 9 for UI. Obviously, this game has been out for 3 years, so honestly, I can't really fault it. In terms of the gameplay itself, it's like really complex, yet really simple at the same time. It's kind of like auto chess or teamfight tactics or those kinds of games, you know? Because it's auto, there's actually like a lot of calculations that you can do. Like for me, it's kind of like there's a Makoto or a Tamaki in position 2. Wow, maybe I should cuck it with like a Maho or a Yuki. And then like, you know, going on to like the guys who came up with like the Reno comp, for example, like, wow, like a lot of thought probably put into that one. And then you got the guys who countered that comp, like, oh my God, it's just everywhere. One thing I don't like about the gameplay is that like a lot of the clan battle, it's already very optimized. There's like not really much creativity that you can do for clan battle. Like everyone's going to be building like the same type of teams. Case in point, I pretty much told you guys what to build in my last video, like those team compositions. Story and production value. Oh my God, I don't even want to click into this because there's just so much. Oh, look at me. I read through the story in another account, don't mind this, but like, wow, it's just an 11 out of 10. There's just so much content, you know, like this is more like a visual novel or like you're playing through an anime. There's just so much going on. There's cinematics, there's fully animated Union Burst, there's big name voice actors and actresses, etc. Once upon a time, a lot of people pumped a lot of love, effort, and money into this game, and we are able to experience that. All right, with that being said, that's kind of like the base game handled. Let's talk about like Crunchyroll and how they've been handling the game so far. Let me start with the overall and the positives kind of thing. I feel like they've done a good job so far. The first topic I want to touch is handling bugs. So there's been a couple of instances of like bugs and stuff like since launch. One of which, like, I think when you bought the Goddess Blessing, it gave you mana as well. And like, it would like crash your game or something, which is absolutely crazy, to be honest. They fixed that reasonably fast and like compensated everyone. Another one that I personally encountered was actually the double drop from dungeon. So everyone above level 60 in that period of time actually did not get their 2x dungeon drops. Again, they fixed it within a couple of days and everyone was quickly compensated. One kind of critique here is like there wasn't any compensation for it. Like a lot of games, it's like they do actually compensate you for having made these kind of bugs or mistakes, right? And I'm not saying this from like an entitled point of view. I'm saying this from like a competitive point of view, where a lot of games give out like apologems. Like Crunchyroll doesn't feel like they haven't given us any at all, right? And a lot of people count apologems towards their gem income every month, which is a little bit weird, but it really does help with the perception of the generosity of the publisher. Either way, they fixed those bugs. It was pretty sweet. On the latest one, if you guys saw my last video, you guys already know, like they banned hackers, which is massive. It's really good. Also, a bit weird that they didn't give comp, but that's okay. Like, let's not get too entitled over here. So honestly, all in all, like their response times to these problems is really, really good. I know it did take like a month and a half or something to fix these like hackers issue, but all in all, I think that's actually a pretty good job. And the fact that they're willing to like weed out the hackers like during the clan battle, I think they said that they're actually going to check to make sure that the clan battles were all like legitimate. That's a pretty solid effort and I applaud their commitment. Next, let's talk about localization and quality of life. So I think they've actually done a really good job like in terms of localization, because they actually keep it really honest to the source material, as far as I can tell. I know a couple of things had to be changed, like Reno. I don't even have Reno. Reno's lines, I think it was just a bit too obscure. Like there are some like Japanese references that we just wouldn't get. And so they just changed it to something else that was equally as cool. As for censorship, I don't think there is actually overly much, if there is any at all. Honestly, everything to me looks fine. Like all the skill names, all of the text, all the stories, everything looks really good to me, to be honest. In terms of quality of life, they actually added sparking relatively early in the game, which is really good. But on top of that, we also also have like almost unlimited skip tickets, and I love that. Also with the clan battle announcement, they've actually added in one of the time features, which is really cool. There's obviously a lot more that they could do, but like, you know, we're getting some, it's trickling down, it's trickle down economics, am I right guys? But for the most part, it feels pretty good to play. Let's talk about the not so great things. First of all, and I don't want to sound like a spoiled brat, but like the launch rewards were kind of stingy. It didn't really feel like we're being showered. And like, you know, normally for gacha games, when they have like the launch celebration rewards, I feel like we usually get showered. And when I mean showered, I mean like, especially for rolls, like really showered. Like I'm playing Blue Archive right now on JP. I think we're up to like 60 rolls. Man, 60 rolls to re-roll with, like everyone is going to have Junin Makoto, man. I really do hope that they loosen up a little bit and be a little bit slightly ever so more generous. Like even better if they're able to match the generosity of the JP version, but only time can tell. Actually on that note, does anyone know the generosity of the other servers like the Thai server or the CN server? If you do know how they're going, please let me know. I'm just really curious to be honest. Another thing that really gets me about Crunchyroll is their communication. It's not really that good. So I really wish that they give like a little preview of like, or sneak peek of the banners or maintenances or stuff like that, right? I think Jita's banner was like revealed one day before or something. And it would be kind of crazy if they announced like clan battle 5 days before clan battles actually started, right? Wait, they did do that. Most casual players are not gonna like even know what CB is. And if you're really that casual, you're only gonna be like reading like in-game notices and stuff like that, and probably not really like following the Twitter or their Facebook page or whatever, right? If they didn't put in that like in-game notice, I think a lot of people would be missing out on that first clan battle actually. And honestly, that would really suck because clan battle is like, to me, it's half the game. The same goes for stuff like the 2x events like Grotto or whatever, right? Like that just got added into the game and there was no announcement anywhere. Like a lot of these things could actually just happen and you would never know that it happened. There was also like that daily gem pack and now that's completely gone, like poof. Like I really think it's in their best interest to like not only inform us about these things but kind of like hype it up as well, right? All right, let's talk about soft launch. Okay, so I'm a soft launch player and I really sympathize for you launch players, especially for clan battle. Like look at this, man, there is just not enough time to get ready, let alone compete. For the brackets in like Battle Arena and Princess Arena, like that really handles it. Like oh my god, I'm in the Kami bracket. Oh Kami, oh god. Wait, I just said the same thing twice. But for clan battle, the gap is just going to be like exceptionally obvious. Like obviously like over time, it's going to flatten out, like especially as we all hit the cap. But it's just not really like a great way to start off the game, right? Because a lot of people are going to feel that like helplessness. They'll always feel like they're left behind from the soft launch players. For the soft launch players, I think a lot of us are like in the maintenance mode, right? Like log in, do dailies, do arenas, and that's kind of it. There haven't been any events and all of that. And I get it, right? If you threw an event into soft launch, it would have probably killed this game on launch. But on the other hand, I understand like having a soft launch because it helps like ease people onto the servers. This may be one of those damning issues where it might make people feel like either bored or burnt out versus like, you know, they'll never catch up even though they will. With that being said, I assure you launch people, like an extra month when we hit 6 months, for example, is going to give us a marginal advantage by then. There is a very real, a very hard wall that we're going to hit that everyone hits. You know what that wall is? It's 5 stars, rank 7, max refine. As long as you're being targeted, focused, and not leveling everybody and their mother, you will be fine. There is no RNG on the equipment. Oh my god, my soul can't handle that anymore. Genshin Epic 7. That wall, a month's progress is not going to make a difference. Trust me on this, guys. Last thing I can add to this is like, you know, maybe the first and the second CB may not be that great for you, but like there will eventually be the 2x drops and the 1.5x EXP events. These kinds of events are actually going to help you catch up to those soft launch capped players, etc. Like if I was level 80 and I got like the 1.5 EXP event, it doesn't help me at all, but it helps you guys catch up. I'm sure it's going to work out in the end, but it's all a matter of perception, right? I know a lot of people who are playing from official launch, they feel like they're really behind and they just don't know any better, and then people are going to leave the game and it's going to be really sad for everybody. I just wish Crunchyroll like maybe held these EXP events or these drop events before CV so that a lot of people could actually catch up. I don't know, I feel really bad for you official launch players. So guys, keep in mind that all of these like praises and criticisms are not only directed at Crunchyroll but also like the game, the whole product as a whole, and that includes Cygames, who are the original publishers. Crunchyroll in my opinion has actually done quite a decent job so far, and obviously there are a lot of things that they could improve on, but I personally don't have any major issues with how they've handled it so far. Like, they didn't release a nerfed version of Jun for... Wait, did they? Oh, somebody better check that, eh? And from what I can tell, nothing looks like a blatant cash grab. I'm pretty sure all of these packs, they're all in JP as well. In summary, I think Princess Connect Global is going pretty well, to be honest. I myself, I'm still enjoying the game so much. And to be honest, I am so grateful that this is more like a side game. It lets me spend so much more time like thinking and theory crafting and actually making these videos for you guys. It's only been like 1.5, 2 months, you know, guys, like give it a bit more time before you start taking out your pitchforks. Like, you know, if something does go wrong, like definitely 100% speak speak up. You know, Tamias did and look what happened. I will definitely be there to call them out as well. But like for now, I think we're doing okay, to be honest. Honestly, I just hope we don't lose this game in 8 months time because like everyone like freaking boycotted it for some stupid reason that Crunchyroll, I don't know, they nerfed Makoto. And I really hope that this game lives very long. All right, guys, that is the end. I would really honestly like to hear your thoughts. You know, I'm a pretty optimistic guy. And I know a lot of you are quite pessimistic. I read through every comment, every single one, and the sentiment has been like really kind of mixed. I'm asking for it today. How do you all feel about where we're going? You know, I'm optimistic and hopeful. And with all that being said, let's wrap it up. Secret message today. There is no secret message, but rather I really want to hear how you feel about the game so far. Are you having fun? Do you think the game is going to live long? What are they doing really well? What do you wish Crunchyroll did better? For me personally, I really like this game and I'm going to play it for quite a while. So that is the secret question of today. As always, if you could drop that in the comments below, I would really appreciate it. I read all of your comments. You already know that. But there are a lot of you now. You're overwhelming me. And I really, really appreciate the support. So thank you so much. I think today we're almost at like 1.3K subscribers. That's freaking crazy. And this is only from like since Precon launched. I am so freaking grateful. So thank you guys so much. And for the last time in this video and probably forevermore, thank you so much for watching. Like, subscribe, comment, you know the works. And I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.